because you can?
It's kind of fun.
Thank you.
You're quite correct, of course. Both the Provincial Army and the Railway Military Police have their own roles to fill, each important to the Empire.
For you, then. How would you respond if a crisis were to occur in multiple places at the same time? Captain Claire Revelt, I presume? It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. I've heard much about you.
It's an honor, Lord Alborea.
Please, no need for formalities between us. Rufus is fine. Still, you seem puzzled as to what I'm doing in Ruhr. Or, to be more specific, how I got here. Do I assume correctly? The country's railways are completely under your control. Had I taken a train, you would have known it. And yet, there are no signs I passed through Ruhr Airport either. The truth is more mundane than fantastic. I arrived aboard the Alborea family's private airship, which currently sits just off a highway on the outskirts of the city awaiting my return. Blind spots are an unavoidable reality. We all have them. As on the ball as you are, you do well not to overestimate your own superiority. After all, the hardest falls are the ones we don't see coming.
I'll be sure to keep that in mind.
Now, isn't it time both sides withdrew? And remove those unsightly vehicles from the streets at once. A provincial army must conduct itself with valor and grace at all times. Would you not agree?
Hey, Lisa.
Oh, it's you. Sorry, were you worried?
A little, yeah. Seeing you like that just kind of reminded me of that night in Nord.
Oh, right. Ugh, I'm so pathetic. I keep going on about how I'm going to be independent, but then I get all worked up over something as trivial as this.
Seeing the city from above at night is really something, though. And to think, you got to take in a beautiful view like this every night growing up.
Yeah, I guess so. It used to be my grandfather, my father, and my mother here. Then after my father died, Sharon joined us. But through the years, my family has always enjoyed seeing the lighted windows of Ruhr at night.
Something that never changed, huh? I guess it is to you what Ymir's mountains are to me.
Maybe every family has something like that. Still, first my grandfather left. And now Sharon and I aren't here most of the time either. Mother just stays here all on her own. Every time I think of that, I just feel like crying. It breaks my heart. I can't understand why she chooses to be so alone.
I thought so. You're not just angry at her, then.
Well, she gets under my skin, that's nothing new. But if I was in her place, I don't know how I'd cope. I couldn't live like she does, losing herself in her work all alone with no friends or loved ones by her side. She wasn't like that before, back when my dad was still alive. She's always been a career woman, but back then she was kind. Funny. She had this warmth, you know? But ever since Dad passed away, she hasn't been the same. Work became her life. She pushed Grandfather out as chairman, all for what? More work? I've never seen her indulge herself. Not even once. If she isn't dining with some business partner, she eats nutrition bars instead of meals. Sharon scolds her for it, but... that's how she is. And that's why I'm scared. I don't want life to just pass her by.
That's really sweet, Elisa.
Where did that come from?
You're always looking out for the people in your life. Even when they get on your nerves, you still care about them. It's like how you and I were at first, or how you were with Laura and Fee. Heck, I still remember how you told me off for hurting my sister's feelings. You've been keeping an eye out for Milliam all this time, too. And you should know that we're all really grateful to you for it. Especially me. I'm worried about what's happening here in Ruhr, too. This is your home, and your mother might be caught up in whatever's going on. I think we should look into it. What do you say?
What? But with all our field study tasks, where would we find the time?
Why not do it while we're out handling those? Making some headway is always better than making none, right? I mean, I'm not the only one who feels this way. Everyone else does too. Fee cares. So does Elliot. Machias does too. Even Crow's been concerned about you. We can use our time in the city to poke around and find out more about what's going on. You know, kind of like we always do.
Well? You say so, but I'll save the thanks for later. I doubt Sharon will tell us anything, no matter how much we pester her. But I'll ask around and see if anyone I know has any idea what might be going on. It shouldn't be too late to give some of them a call, at least.
All right, I'll leave the info gathering to you. Once we get our task list tomorrow, we can discuss how we want to do this.
All right. Anyway, I think I'm going to start calling my contacts. And one more thing. If I were you, I wouldn't go around stroking girls' heads like that. I mean, you don't just go whispering sweet nothings into any girl's ear, do you? This isn't so different, really.
Huh? Oh. I guess you're right. Sorry. It's something I always did to my sister when she was feeling down. But now that you mention it, she did seem to resent it more as she got older. But when I stopped doing it, she called me insensitive and got all upset anyway.
I think your sister and I would have a lot to talk about. But anyway, I'll see you later.
All right.
Oh, good, it went through. Glad I was able to get your number from Milliam. It is. I apologize for calling so late. Are you free right now? There's something important I'd like to discuss with you. But it's a matter best discussed in person. Would it be possible for you to meet me in the city? Sooner is preferable. Technically speaking, yes. But with the provincial army on alert, traveling in a large group would draw too much suspicion. That's why I decided to contact you directly. You're the team leader. Outside of the elevated walkway, you'll see a bar called F. It's a quiet, upscale establishment, the perfect place for a private discussion. I'll be waiting. I'm not on a schedule or anything, though, so there's no need to rush. You've got time. And by the way, I'd rather you didn't mention any of this to Elisa. Because what I want to discuss with you happens to involve the Reinford Company. But I'll leave it to your discretion. Anyway, you know where to find me.